YouTube, social media world. It's your boy Anonymous based in on biggity biggity bat with a new reaction video. This time I'm here with something brand new from It's Complicated. But before we get into that, if you're new to the channel, go ahead and give this video a like. Share with a couple of your friends. Make sure you follow me on my social media sites. And if you got something specific, go ahead and drop it in that comment section. So we are here with something brand new from It's Complicated. Shout out to you, brother. Dom DeMarco. And the name of this video is called Emotionally Unavailable. Rules of Modern Dating and Understanding Women. All right, let's go ahead and get into it, man. I'm eager to see what this one's going to be about.
Have you ever ghosted somebody? And if so, why?
Because I was in a relationship.
Oh. Yes, definitely. And probably because I didn't want to confront him.
And I'm really bad at confrontation. Honestly, that's why.
I have not ghosted somebody. I'm pretty honest about telling them that I don't want communication and for whatever reason it is.
I had only known them for one night and they had called me 6 times and texted me 12 times.
Okay, yeah, that's fair.
The night right after meeting, and it scared me away, to be honest.
Being a bugaboo.
Are women more likely to give out their number and ghost men, or are men more likely to get a girl's number and not call?
I'll get your number and ghost you.
Women are most definitely more likely to get a guy's number and ghost them.
There you go.
It's hard to
say no then and there, so when we get the number, we can just like block them and be like, okay.
It's hard being a woman when you're asked for your number and you kind of feel a pressure to say yes, even if you're not interested.
Stop the cap.
Women are definitely more likely to go ghost men because men are fucking creepy as hell, and there's a lot more of them that are being creepy as hell than women are. So for sure, you know, they're going to say, oh yeah, sure, take my number, and then just forget about it.
Yep.
I know for sure that that's a fact.
Yep.
Why don't women typically approach men?
Intimidation.
If you're like out at a bar or something, you know, maybe you just want a free drink.
I don't think it's very traditional. I think it's always kind of been the way that a man...
What are we looking at?
And... will approach a woman.
Also, I think it's a big confidence thing for women. You know, I know it's hard definitely to approach a man in any context. And I think doing it and succeeding, even in just saying hello, can be a big confidence booster.
If women are the ones who fear rejection, why are women always the ones complaining about men not showing their emotions?
Oh,
I don't know. I don't know if they're necessarily putting their emotions on the line just because they're the ones approaching us. You know what I mean? Because isn't it like a two-way street when we're both having a conversation? We kind of have to both be emotionally available. Just because you're the one that approaches me doesn't necessarily mean that you're more emotionally aware of your feelings than I am, you know?
Let me ask you this. Who's more likely to play hard to get, men or women?
Uh-oh.
Women. Probably, yeah, women. Definitely.
So then gotcha, wouldn't that mean that women are the ones who are more emotionally unavailable?
I think that's... Okay, because gotcha, I think women have more emotional intelligence, then yes, I agree. You're right. I think you're right.
Cut that out, you little bastard.
Girls will play hard to get, but guys will turn the table and play hard to get to keep it interesting and fresh.
If men risk rejection, wouldn't that mean men are the ones who are more emotionally available because they're the first ones to be vulnerable?
Ooh, honestly, I would say yes when you put it in those terms, although I don't think we think about it that way in society.
Do you believe that being in love requires you to be vulnerable?
Yes.
How can you be vulnerable without being taken advantage of?
Just be yourself.
You can and you will be taken advantage of, but yeah. You have to know that your partner has your best interest in mind, because it's a big aspect of trust.
Okay.
Trust is always the most important thing about relationships, and that's why you need to be vulnerable in order to have love, and you can't, you know, be vulnerable unless you're trusting.
Who's more likely to play hard to get, men or women?
Honestly, I think women. I think women are very calculated, not necessarily in a bad way when it comes to dating, but there's a lot of thought that goes into literally every single thing you do.
If the answer is women, wouldn't that mean women are the ones who are more emotionally unavailable?
Yeah. I mean, I think it can be hard for a woman.
Fuck nigga to the end, tell a friend, bitch.
To like let your guard down. I think it can be very difficult, and sometimes playing those sort of games and playing hard to get can kind of be like a defense mechanism almost.
Like when we're looking for something, we're looking for something and just like no games.
If women want men to just be themselves, why is approaching women a skill men need to learn? Why does he need game?
Well, he needs game because like we're not gonna be the first to approach you, and like the way you approach us is like how we're gonna go about it, so you have to have game.
So if women aren't going to approach because they you know, want the man to do it, then why don't we say that women are the ones who are emotionally unavailable?
I'm emotionally unavailable. I'm a gotcha, bitch! So.
See?
How should a man know if a girl genuinely likes him or if she just wants attention?
That's a hard... I think that's a question that will never be answered. That's very complicated.
If she's putting in the effort to actually talk to him and text him...
He's a womanizer. Don't listen to shit he's saying.
What?
I think if a male can take attention away from a female and she could find a way of still sticking around, you know, I think that's a pretty good indicator that she sees something else than just the short-term attention. Because seeking attention is a short-term behavior. Yeah. It's not a long-term aspect of female behavior. Okay. You know, if they're waiting around, they're looking for something, you know, that's the best indicator that they see something else other than just seeking that short-term attention.
Dating culture is so hard nowadays. Like, if you really want to be with somebody, they will, you don't need to question it. You know, they will make it known. So don't, if you have to question whether someone likes you, they probably don't like you.
But since women are the ones who are more emotionally unavailable, how is a man supposed to know?
That's a good question. How's it going? Because that woman will make it known when she is available.
Okay. So then why aren't women the ones who pursue and chase men?
I just don't think that could be a general thing. I mean, I think women don't chase men because of the stereotype that men are supposed to do a lot of things first. But at the end of the day, I think times are changing and men are hopefully being more, you know, emotional and women are taking a step forward, but some guys don't like a forward woman. Trust me, I know that from experience.
Why wouldn't they like that when it makes it easier for them?
Because some men like that damsel kind of. So everyone's different, you know, like the puzzle piece. You find your puzzle piece. You know, some people like someone who's more head on, and then other people just like someone who's more like. Guys like the chase, like, you know, they're predators.
I think women like the chase because women are the ones who enjoy.
Women do like the chase. I think we all like the chase because they're animals.
I think men like the catch because I think men like the catch because the catch is when men get laid, and that's why men pursue women, right?
True.
So why do so many women think men like the chase when men actually like the catch and women like the chase?
Women like the chase, but they don't like to get.
Why are women typically the ones who think they should define love and emotions?
Because men don't. Society and societal standards and the stories that we're told growing up. You know, we grow up on stories of women being caretakers and being nurturers and how we learn that love is kind of the end-all be-all, even though that's not necessarily true.
Is it harder for men to express their emotions or is it harder for women to withhold their emotions?
Ooh. I think both. I actually think both.
Ooh.
Because my boyfriend, he's actually like a... like an onion. You have to peel him off for him to talk about how he feels. And I talk too much about how I feel.
So if he's an onion, does he make you cry?
Sometimes.
Do men have to express their emotions in order to prove they experience emotions?
I feel like they do, yeah.
You know, be a man, keep it to yourself, don't cry, because guys don't cry. Which is sad, because there's a lot of problems and issues with that. But I guess just that's how we were raised.
Why do women often complain that men don't express their emotions?
Because, like, I feel like guys are always guarded. And then, like, if they feel something, they just walk away or they just don't want to say it. So it's, like, us that always has, like, the emotion and the feelings.
You know, men are not expected to show their emotions. They're expected to be tough and look after whoever they're going to look after. And women are looking for a man that can go provide in that way and be able to hunt for whatever that is. If it's not meat, it's going to be money. If it's not money, it's going to be something else. But women are looking for that because they're looking for those providers.
Women can also definitely be emotionally unavailable in the sense that they don't always show their emotion, even though we're taught to think that they do. So I think when it comes to men, it's about kind of turning that around and thinking that a man can also be emotional, but maybe has trouble opening up. But I think actions can also say a lot about emotion and doesn't necessarily need to be words.
Okay.
Do you believe that being emotional entitles women to sympathy or special treatment?
I think that depends on the person because that's not really on the women. If we're more emotional just because we have more, you know, hormones and we're more expressive with our feelings, doesn't necessarily mean we want sympathy or we want to get that. But if that's the way that the man feels, like they're like, oh, you crying, so I automatically feel bad. That's not really our fault in that. Do you see what I'm saying?
Where is the line between being very emotional and being bipolar?
When you get diagnosed with bipolar.
Why do women often say they want a man to be more in their feminine side, but you rarely hear men say they want women to be more in their masculine side?
Men in their feminine side is just sexy. I mean, when they're vulnerable and they can just be themselves and they kind of, you know, they like to be pampered too, so.
I think that has a lot to do with toxic masculinity, which also greatly affects men.
Here we go. Here we go.
I think that when a woman sees a man who can sort of embrace that quote-unquote feminine side, I think it's really... I think it goes back to emotion and showing that a man really can be emotional and be vulnerable.
Cut that out, you little bastard!
Is it harder for men to express their emotions, or is it harder for women to withhold their emotions?
Harder for women to withhold their emotions, for sure.
Okay.
Harder for a man to express. Yeah.
Is it harder for women to be logical, or for men to be emotional?
Women.
Damn, son, where'd you find this?
Again, it's very traditional, and guys not showing emotion.
If men are more logical and women are more emotional, why can't we just accept that men and women are probably more sexually compatible than they are emotionally compatible?
I think because today a lot of people, specifically in Generation Z, have kind of gone away from that stereotype and that way of thinking. And I think that that's probably something that people have always kind of secretly thought and felt. But today we're just a lot more vocal about it. So I think... people really do believe that men and women can be emotionally compatible as well as sexually. They just won't speak it out loud.
Can you think of a time where being emotional got you into trouble?
Oh, absolutely.
Got me into trouble, meaning like I got told by my ex-boyfriend that I was manipulative because I was emotional.
Oh.
Maybe just kind of expressing too much and speaking more than I should have when I should have just not said something.
Has there ever been a time when being rational kept you out of trouble?
Yes. Me personally, I'm definitely a problem solver, but I am also very emotional, so I kind of have to use both sides, especially if I'm in a situation where I find myself getting emotional and just really think logically and use my critical thinking and kind of just calm myself down and keep myself out of trouble, even if it's like trouble from myself.
Has there ever been a time when being rational kept you out of trouble?
No.
What?
Can you think of any situation where being rational wouldn't outweigh being emotional?
No. I think sometimes being too rational and logical when you are trying to be vulnerable and open up can kind of backfire, and you might overthink and lose that confidence that you had to be vulnerable with another person.
Many women want men to be more emotional. Why should men be expected to be more emotional like women instead of women expected to be more rational like men?
To be honest, men just need to be emotional because, like, y'all just suck nowadays.
Stop the cap.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. These situationships out here just suck, so...
expressing feelings can kind of symbolize like weakness, so it is nice when a guy is kind of raw and open with you.
Not a lot of people are gonna like this answer, but I think that that women are actually testing men to see how strong they are. And I think that's a strong thing that women do naturally. It's like they need to know that the man that they're with is a strong provider, is a strong individual with strong character, and they do this to see if a man's gonna crack. And yep. Like, I think it's fine if a man wants to express his emotions, but I also think it's more important that he needs to hold up a strong front and show that in the very, very, very tough and chaotic situations where no one knows what's going on, that a woman could still trust her man to make the decision and solve the problem.
If most women aren't interested in a soft, vulnerable man, why are they often trying to get a man to express his emotions and be more vulnerable?
I think, again, it can go back to a woman wanting a man to show that they care about her.
They need to know that man actually has the capability of caring for something, and that's actually a really desirable trait, to go care for something like a child or for a community or
so good, so good, so they got all the gifts you need when you're rolling through the rack. Grandma's got a lot of drip, but she likes to kick back. So
or for anything else around them. And in order to have a demonstration of that care, there needs to be some level of emotion that can be expressed. No matter how small it is, but even some level is enough to demonstrate that.
What do you think about the mixed messages men face that encourage him to be both strong and tough, but also open and vulnerable?
I think it can definitely be confusing. And I think, women also can experience these mixed messages as well as men.
Sweet and submissive and strong and independent, right?
Yeah, exactly.
And we don't tell you how to do that, though.
It can be really hard when your role models are, you know, very masculine people that you're taught to look up to your whole life. But then, you know, you're grown up and people want you to be this different side. And I think it can be really confusing.
What does the expression man up mean?
Man up means it's the same lesson we've taught all men throughout history. It's like batten, beated, bruised, but not beaten. You pick yourself up, you dust yourself off, and you keep going.
Be brave. Don't be afraid. Don't show that you're hurting or that you're showing any emotion at all, really.
Does the expression man up only apply to straight men?
No, I don't think so. I think any man of any sexuality can definitely still have those stereotypes influenced on them.
If women are so concerned with feelings and emotions, why will some shame a man who cries or needs emotional support unless he's gay?
Because I think it's seen as being weak, as a weakness. So obviously a girl isn't going to be very attracted to weak.
They're not. If a straight guy is acting weak, I think that gets rid of the, I don't know. I feel like for women, that gets rid of the attractiveness, whether if they, like, saw a gay guy, like, crying, they'd be like, oh, what's wrong? Like, how can I help you? Just because, like, there's no, like, connection there, you know?
We need someone to be tough. Someone must be tough. And the person that is most likely to be tough, if we're looking across, you know, whether male or female, it's going to be mostly the male.
Yep.
We need to send someone off to battle. If we need someone, send someone off to hunt. If we need send someone off to do something extremely tough and uncomfortable, more likely than not, it's going to be the man.
Yep.
And the woman is going to thank the man for doing so.
Yep.
More times than not.
What do you think about the mixed messages men face that encourage him to be both strong and tough, but also open and vulnerable?
I honestly think it could be pretty confusing sometimes of just how society wants men to act. It's confusing. I think it just blurs a lot of lines.
How about it's complicated?
It's complicated.
It's complicated.
It's complicated. It's complicated.
There you go. All right, man. Shout out to It's Complicated for coming through with another fire video called Emotionally Unavailable. Okay, so first impressions of me watching this. This one was definitely right on point. This was on par. He had some really good questions, and it caused some great interactions, some great feedback, some great responses, and a little bit of critical thinking was triggered in this video. Now, there was quite a bit of cap. Not gonna lie, man.
Stop the cap.
There's quite a bit of capping going on. But for the most part, that one guy that was standing there with, I guess that was his girlfriend, that dude was on point with everything he was saying. That dude was 100% on point. He kept it factual. He kept it logically sound. And he was logically consistent with everything he said. And overall, it was a great video. Have nothing bad to say about the content. Just keep on doing your thing, Mr. Is Complicated. And one more shout out to you. And with that being said, that's pretty much my reaction, man. So if you like the video, go ahead and give this video a like. Share with a couple of your friends. Make sure you follow me on all my social media sites. And if you got something specific, go ahead and drop it in that comment section, man. It's your boy, Anonymous Bass. Peace.